The root of helping kids develop math fact fluency is through the connections and relationships of numbers that we can help them develop. The more connections and relationships they develop, the more fluent they will become. But most resources that you can find out there around fact fluency are just a bunch of worksheets. I'm Christina Tondevold, the Recovering Traditionalist, and today we're going to take a look at my favorite resources for math fact fluency in our quest to build our math minds so we can build the math minds of our students. Now, I've done lots of other videos about what fact fluency really is and how you can help build it for your students. And so I'm going to link up a few of those down below this video, but you can also find all of them over at the vlog, therecoveringtraditionalist.com. Just search on that page for fact fluency and they will all come up. I also have a fact fluency starter kit that you can request and it'll be down below this video. So for anybody who is new here, I'll give you a brief little overview. I don't believe in having kids just memorize their facts. I don't believe in drills and worksheets. My belief is based in the research of many researchers, including Carpenter, Vandewall, Barodi, Wheatley and Reynolds, Fosno, and many, many more. But this belief is basically the idea that, and it's proven by research, that kids develop their fluency through a progression, and that progression starts by counting, and it moves into developing relationships around numbers, and then yes, it becomes just something they know. Like, think of 7 plus 8. Yes, we all as adults know that 7 plus 8 is 15. But when young kids first start out, they start out by counting out the 7, counting out the 8, and then counting them all to figure out it's 15. And then we eventually get to where if we just jump them to, hey, we're going to memorize 7 plus 8 is 15. We want them to just know the answer. If they don't just know the answer, they drop all the way back down to that counting phase. And it also doesn't help develop some good thinking either. All it is memorization, and that's not what mathematics is really about. So let's come back to that 7 plus 8. I might think of that problem a bit different than you think about that problem. And that's what happens with our kids, is that how they think about 7 plus 8 is all based upon the relationships and connections they have built around those numbers. Now, I personally really like when things are connected to 10. I like to make tens or multiples of tens. So when I see 7 plus 8, I instantly want to make a 10. And I could make a 10 with the 7, I could make a 10 with the 8, but my preference usually is to just do the first one. If they're fairly close, you know, if I was doing something with like 9 and 6, then I'd use the 9. But 7 and 8 really doesn't matter which one you're using. They're both really close to 10. So I might go with, you know, bringing 3 over to the 7, that makes 10 and it leaves 5. So I've got 10 and 5. But somebody else might look at that, like let's say somebody is really into football. You've got a student who is so into football and they see 7 plus 8 and they go, that's really close to 7 plus 7 because I know that from football scores. And so 7 plus 7 is 14. So 7 plus 8 is just going to be one more. It'll be 15. Though that's what I'm talking about building those connections. And the more connections and relationships they have around number, the more fluent your students are going to become. So when people ask me for resources to help them with fact fluency, it's hard for me because first, I want to make sure that people understand fact fluency is not the same as memorization. So if fluency is really your key, the goal, if fluency is really your goal, it does not come from memorization. Sure, kids can memorize their facts and they'll be able to regurgitate answers, but they're not truly fluent. And again, if you want more info on what makes somebody truly fluent, go reference the other videos that I've done, okay? But if you understand that fluency is not just memorization and you're ready, you want to start building these relationships for kids, helping kids see connections, then this video is gonna give you 3 of my favorite resources to help you do that. All right, you ready? Okay, so the first one is a website by Sue Looney. It's called Same But Different. Now, for those of you who are members of the Build Math Minds PD site, you guys have access to an hour-long training that Sue did all about Same But Different for the virtual math summit. So if you are in Build Math Minds, go over there, take a look. You get in-depth training from Sue about that. So let's take a look though, for people who aren't, let's go over to Same But Different and take a look at the website and what these really mean. So on this site, she's got tons of them that are categorized by whichever kind of topic you are wanting to build. So even though we're focused on fact fluency, you don't have to do same but different tasks that are focused on facts. So let me, I'll jump into an addition and subtraction one. But the general idea of same but different is that you're looking at these images and you're talking about what is the same and what is different. And that is the key to helping kids build relationships around number. When they see 7 + 8, how is that the same as 7 + 7? If they get used to looking for same but different scenarios, like in images and any kind of situations, then they're more apt to see those things when it comes to building their fact fluency. So these types of tasks, it doesn't have to be around addition and subtraction, but any type of same but different task will help build that skill of looking for things that are the same and things that are different, right? So here's one with these teddy bears. And so this could be linked to help kids see how 2 + 2 is the same but different than 3 + 1. Right? You're building those connections, helping kids see relationships. Here's another teddy bear one that on the image on the left, you can see 4 and 4. And then on the image on the right, we still have that 4 + 4, but now we've got one more. So it's helping kids see a double 4 + 4, and then how that is the same yet different than 4 + 5. And helping kids use something they know to help them with something they don't know. That is a big part of helping kids develop fact fluency, and same but different tasks are a great way to do that with your students. Another favorite resource are number strings. I love number strings. They're one of my favorite things to help build connections and relationships between images, problems, numbers, whatever it might be. If you're not familiar with number strings, I'll link down below here a TEDD.org website that gives a great general overview of number strings and then how to use them along with sample number strings. Once you understand how to use them, then I want you to go to numberstrings.com because they have a vast resource of number strings that you have access to for free. So on numberstrings.com, they have a great example of what a number string looks like and how it's made. But basically, it is you have kind of what's considered a helper problem, and then a problem that's maybe a little bit more difficult, then a helper problem, and then one that's more difficult. And then at the end, you give one of the problems that's more difficult without a helper problem. So you're helping kids try to make connections between something they know and something they don't know, which is the general idea of a number string. On this website, you have a ton of resources. So on the main page, it's kind of like their blog where they talk about implementing number strings in the classroom. And the great thing is it is a community of educators who've put this site together. So they're sharing stuff from all different grade levels. And up here at the top, you can sort things by whichever type. So if I want things that are for addition, I can come into here and find ones that are specifically about addition or multiplication or whatever they might be, whatever you are looking for, you can find on the Number Strings website. So it's an excellent free resource that will get your kids to talk and start noticing relationships and connections between mathematical ideas. Our last resource is, again, it's one of my favorites. These are all my favorites. I have a lot more, but I don't want to overwhelm you. So we are starting with just my top three. So my last one I'm going to share with you for today is Berkeley Everett's Math Flips. Berkeley Everett decided he did not like the normal flashcards. So he created these flashcards that on his website, this is direct quote from his from the website, Math Flips are flashcards with a problem on the front and a similar problem on the back, instead of a problem and an answer, to encourage relational thinking rather than answer getting. We want kids to look at relationships. That's what I said at the beginning of this video. We want them to notice relationships and connections, not just this problem means this answer. That's unidirectional. We want them to see all the connections because research has shown the more connections our brain has built around something, the easier it is for us to recall that information when we need it. So these flashcards are a great way to help kids do that. So on his site, he's got videos, he's got information about how to use these, and he's got the download so that you can download and start using this resource right away with your students. If you're not familiar with Math Flips, go there now and get the download and start using them with your kids. It's just to get them to start talking about what they're noticing about how one problem relates to another problem. That's all we're doing. That's what we need to do, and that builds more fluency for your students. Now, don't get me wrong, these are not the only resources out there that will help your kids build and see connections in mathematics, but these three are the place I would start to get you going on that path. Get your students doing these three types of activities, and you will see them start to build relationships, make connections, and start developing their own strategies that will help them build their fact fluency. All right, I hope that this video has helped you build your math mind so you can go build the math minds of your students. Have a great day.